Okay, so last time we were discussing sums of vector spaces. So remember, we start with a vector space over a fixed field, let's call it V, and then take two of its subspaces. These are vector space, U and omega, their subspaces. So actually U and omega are subsets of V, and since V is a vector space, there are two operations defined on it. And when you restrict these operations to these subsets U and omega, they are also vector spaces with the same operations. And then we discussed whether U intersection omega is also a subspace of V, and the answer was yes. But U union W is not always a subspace. Instead of taking unions, we consider taking sums. By U plus omega, we mean U plus omega will be a subspace. We proved this. And the elements of U plus omega will be sums of elements, one from U, one from omega. So in U plus omega, you have sums of elements coming from U and omega. And there is a special type of sums, namely the direct sum. If U plus omega is a direct sum, by definition, it means that every element has a unique expression in this form as a sum of elements from U and another element from omega. And actually we proved that it is enough to check how many different ways you can write the zero vector, because if you have the zero vector, there is one obvious way. Zero is equal to zero plus zero. If you can express zero in another way, it means that sum is not direct sum. For if you have two subspaces of a given vector space, it is easy to understand whether this sum is a direct sum or not. You need to check whether their intersection is just the zero vector. Okay, so let's see the proof of this. Proof. Now let us first suppose that this sum is a direct sum. Suppose U plus omega is a direct sum. Okay. Now, in this case, we are going to show that in the intersection of U and omega, we cannot have a non-zero vector. Tamam mı? Uygun mu? Peki, teşekkür ederim. Now, let us take an element from the intersection of these subspaces that V in U intersection omega. Okay, then now look, if this V, this vector V happens to be a non-zero vector, this implies that you can write the zero vector in this way also, V plus minus V, because this V is in U. If V is in, or V is also in omega, so minus V, because omega is also a vector space, minus V should also belong to omega. So this is in U, this is in omega. So you write zero as a sum of a vector from U, a vector from omega. If V is non-zero, this will contradict that this summation is a direct sum, because then you can write zero at least in two different ways. Tamam mı? Yaman? Peki. V is in U, omega v minus v in omega. Now unique representation. Of zero vector implies that v is equal to the zero vector. Do we have any questions about this proof? Do we have any questions? Ümmü Gülsüm? Tamam mıyız? Tepki verin. Parmağınızı kilitletin. Güzel, o da olur. Şuradan birisine daha sorayım. Uğur Altıntaş.
Tamamdır hocam.
Teşekkür. Okay. Now let us suppose that we have two subspaces whose intersection consists of only the zero vector. Suppose U intersection V is just, pardon, U intersection omega is just the zero vector. Now, how can we check whether a given sum is a direct sum or not? We need to see whether there are more than one ways to write the zero vector as a sum. Evet mi? Sana soruyorum. Remember, you have two subspaces and you know what type of elements are here. For this sum, tamam mıyız? Şimdi tepki vermezsiniz. Ben size bakarım, siz de bana bakarsınız. Öyle bakışır dururuz. Ben size baktım ama böyle. Şimdi ilerleriz. If you have a sum, if you have a sum for this sum to be a direct sum, any element here must be written in a unique way as a sum of one vector from here, one vector from here. And what did we prove? You don't need to check all the vectors. If you just check the zero vector, the ways that you can express zero vector as a sum of vectors from these two subspaces, it is enough. What is good about the zero vector? Because you already know how to write the zero vector as a sum, zero plus zero. If you can express zero in another way, a non-zero vector here and a non-zero vector from here, then your sum is not a direct sum. Now we are assuming that we have two subspaces of the given vector space V, namely U and omega, and their intersection is just the zero vector. Now, and let us assume that this is how we represent, how we express the zero vector. U plus omega. Tamam. Of course, this U is in U. This is in omega. Okay. Now, what does this imply? This implies that this omega is equal to negative of U. If omega is negative, U is a vector in this subspace. U is a vector in this vector space. So if U is in this vector space, any multiple of this vector must also be in this vector space. Because this is closed under scalar multiplication. If U is in U, negative U must also belong to this vector space. Değil mi? If omega is negative of U, then it must belong to also this set U. So omega is an element both in omega and U. And what does this imply? Omega is nothing but the zero vector. And let me tell you, there's nothing wrong putting an arrow on top of these vectors. I tend to put a zero arrow on top of zero because there is this zero scalar and the zero. Tamam. Any questions? Anar?
No question hocam.
Ben de dedim şampiyon challenge'ım. Okay. Now Mustafa nerede? Bizden Mustafa yok. Ha, Mustafa orada kedi. Okay. Now first omega is negative u. So omega must belong to u. Omega belongs to omega. Omega belongs to u. So omega must be in the intersection. So omega is zero and of course u is zero also.
You just write omega and the first example of x on the top. You just have a
ne diyorum? Onları sanmıyorum.
Tabii neden? You didn't write
during equal to zero. Aynı. Şuradan dolayı yazmaya gerek görmüyorum. Yazabiliriz. Tamam. Are you happy now? Now last time Mustafa Görkem asked the question about direct sums of more than two vector spaces. Now giving a condition is not easy. If you are wondering about start with a vector space V and consider three of its vector spaces. V1, V2, V3. And then we can talk about the subspace V1 plus V2 plus V3. So we can define that subspace and then ask this question with whether this sum, the given sum, is a direct sum or not. How can we check whether this is a direct sum or not? And in one of our previous examples, we had three vector spaces. For R3, we have three vector spaces, U1, U2, U3. And pairwise intersection of these three subspaces are just the zero vector, but their sum is not a direct sum. Hatırladınız mı? Now, so you may try to prove this. If you have three subspaces of a given vector space, let's say U1, U2, U3, if U1 intersection, U2 plus U3, is the zero vector. U2 intersection U1 plus U3 is the zero vector. And similarly, U3 intersection U1 plus U2 is the zero vector. Then U1 plus U2 plus U3 is a direct sum. So it is giving a condition for more than two spaces is not that easy. Tamam. You may try to prove this. Okay. We will go with the two subspaces case. Okay. Now, any questions here? Yok. Okay. Now, let me ask you a question. Prove or give a counter example if U1, U2, omega are subspaces of V such that V is equal to U1 direct sum omega and is equal to U2 direct sum omega, then U1 is equal to U2. Evet. Prove or disprove? Of course, disprove means give a counter example. Evet. And this is one of these times where there are some points involved here. Evet. Prove or disprove? You have 1 minute, ne yazık ki. Ha, ben göremiyorsunuz. Disprove. Yes, Anar, what is your example? Counter example. Unmute yourself. Unmute yourself. Anar. Anar, that is not an example. Meme. Anar. Buraya bir şeyler yazıyor da. Saymıyor. Evet, sınıftan varsa.
Hocam, if you take u1 x0,
yes,
where x takes all the values from real line, real field, whatever.
Okay, let me write. Okay, here is Anar's potential example. You, what is our vector space? What is V?
R2, hocam.
R2. What is U1?
X0.
Good. What is U2?
0y.
Good. And omega.
And it can be MM or ZZ, whatever okay. It is.
So what he's trying to say is take any line passing through the origin with a positive, with a non-zero or infinite slope. So let's say X, X in R2. Okay. Now, nazar etme ne olur. Okay, now let's see whether this example works or not. U1 plus omega. X comma zero, X comma X. So if you consider, U1 plus U1 plus omega. Is this a direct? Arkadaş kumdan mı yaptınız? Is this a direct sum? Is this a direct sum?
Yes.
Yes. And this is because their intersection is just the zero vector and also for the same reason, this is also a direct sum because this is just a zero vector. When I was a student, I had some problems thinking about the intersection of those two. X var, X var. Sanki X comma zero sadece sıfır değil gibi geliyordu bana. Sana duyuyor da öyle geliyor mu? Bana da öyle gelirdi. Soramazdım da. Mesela Nazlı'ya da öyle. Şimdi genel olarak şöyle düşünün. Bir yeri anlayamadığınız zaman, diyelim ki anlayamadınız. Şöyle bir etrafınıza bakın. Sonra bu dediğime hak vereceksiniz. Bir şey anlayamadığınız zaman şöyle düşünün. Bunu ben anlayamadıysam hiç kimse anlayamamıştır. Ha diyeceksiniz ki ya yok herkes, herkes aynı yüz ifadesiyle bakıyor. Ben buradan Elif alınmayacak diye ona söylüyorum. Şimdi başlıyoruz. Ben de öyle. Şimdi x var. X virgül sıfır sanki kesişimleri gibi gelirdi bana. Soru soramazdım. Arada şey yaptım. Ya evet ben de anlamadım onu. Ama kimse sormuyor. Siz anlayamadıysanız kesin %90'ı sınıfın anlamamıştır. Tamam. Onun için çekinmeden sorun. Ha, ben dalga geçeyim o benim ayıbım. Ama ne yapayım elimde değil yani. Evet. Tamam. Now here you may think it like this. Your vector spaces are two and you are looking at the x-axis. Here you are looking at the y is equal to x line. These two will coincide when x here is equal to zero. And similarly these two will intersect when y is equal to zero. Tamam? Anlaştık. Now, so these are direct sums. And the next question is, because we want this to direct sum to give us R vector space R2. And the next question is, can we write any vector in R2 as a sum of a one vector from U1 and another vector from omega? So whatever you give a vector here, sen neyse olsan, give me a vector in R2. Alıştı bak. Bir de benim halimi düşünün. Sürekli bir şeyler uydurmak zorundayım. Sen neydin ya? Sen Gül. Bir vektör ver. Ben öğrenciyken var ya neden korkar değil mi? Adam bir vektör ver dediğinde acaba doğru mu anladın? Yani bu ilk İngilizce öğrenirken hoca bir şey soruyor. Sen anlamıyorsun. Şimdi how old are you diyor hoca. Bana olmuştu da. Çünkü ben kesin how are you diye soracak bana diye bekliyordum. Yok pardon. How old are you? Öyle bir şeyler derdi. How are you dedi. Ben de I am bilmem ne years old dedim. Öyle bir duruma düşerim diye üniversite hayatım boyunca vektör verdiyse bir de vermezdim. Ne demek istiyorum? Bir vektör ver. 3-5. Okay. Now let's take the vector 3,5. If you want to write 3,5, one vector from U1 and another vector from omega, how should you take your vectors? 3,5. If you take 3,5 from R2, then it would be 5,5 from omega and negative 2,0 from U2. Because since the second component of this vector is zero, you need to get the second component only from omega. And if you want to write 3,5 as an element in this subspace, then you need to take again this as 5,5, 3,2. Tamam. So both of these direct sums will give you R2. We are going to see more examples of such cases because maşallah esneyim. So this is going to be more clear because we are going to say that this two has a meaning. This will be a vector space and so on. But for now you can check it by hand like this. So both of them give you your vector space R2. You have these omegas here, but you can, after cancellation, U1 is not equal to U2. So this statement is not true. Tamam? Good. Or you can think it like this. For R3, take any plane passing through the origin. It is a subspace in R3. A plane passing through the origin is a subspace. Now, if you take any line passing through the origin, which is not on this plane, these two will span R3, will give you their sum will be direct sum. And their direct sum will give you R3. Tamam, neyse. But this is, did you understand this example? İnşallah bu videoları izlerim sonra.
Hocam ben anlamadım ya son kısmı.
Hangi, benim hangi kısmı? Buradaki mi?
Yok, sağ üstte.
Sağ, şurası. Burası değil mi? Burada mı?
Evet.
Tamam. Okay. We observe that these summations, sums u1 plus omega and u2 plus omega are direct sums. Because their intersection is just a zero vector. Tamam. Next, we need to make sure that we have v. So any element in v can be, so don't forget this set, this subspace on the right hand side is actually u1 plus omega, where u1 intersection omega is just the zero vector. This is the subspace on the right hand side. You have the subspace u2 plus omega plus an additional property. The intersection of u2 and omega is just the zero vector. Now, if this is going to be true, you should be able to write any vector in V, NAR2, as a sum of one vector from here and another vector from here. So for example, if you take the vector 3, 5 in R3, R2, actually Ata Doruk's example is better. So let me explain this. If you take this, since this 5, look at the elements of u1 and omega. So when you look at the elements of u1 and omega, so this second component will be obtained by omega, because the second component of the elements of u1 are always zero. So you should take 5, 5 here. And then to get this 3, you should get negative 2, 0. And similarly, here 3, 3, this time the first component, right? Or in general, evet, ama oraya gelmedik Merve. Atadoruk Aydın, give a general way to write these elements. Değil mi Atatürk? Ya da ne bileyim bir şey yazmıştı. Evet evet, Atatürk's example is better. Not. Kim sormuştu bu soruyu?
Ben sormuştum.
Sen, adın ne?
Fırat.
Fırat Karadeniz.
Evet. Hocam ben şeyi anlamadım. U1'la U2 birbirine eşit oldu mu olmadı mı? Çünkü oraya...
Hayır olmadı. This is false. And this is a counter example.
Tamam anladım şimdi.
This statement is false. Tamam. Hayır. Omega, these are the same subspace ama aldığım elemanlar farklı. Ama bu burada. İkisi de burada. Tamam birisi. Peki. Anar. Abdullah'ı. Demedim. Prove or disprove?
No, I don't know. I think we should take same number of subspaces, for example, S.
No, I don't. Böyle bir şey değil. So, of course, when you express, so this is just an example. So, if you If you consider the sum of U1 and omega, the subspace, these two subspaces, it will give us the vector space V. Yo, bir tane örnek diyor. 3-5'i elde. Yani U1 vektör space ile V omega'yı topladığım zaman büyük V vektör space'ini verecek. 3-5 ile ilgili bir şey soruyorsun sen.
Hocam mesela
5-5 yazdık ya. 5-5 yanında aldık diyor. Hayır. 8'de 2 tane sayının toplamı olarak söylüyor. 4-6-4. Tamam, ben 2+6 yazdım. Yani bütün elemanları Allah'a da örneğinden bir fark verirse ama neyse. Tamam mıyız? Anlaştık, çok güzel. Good. For T. Now we are now Merve's section. Remember, if you have a vector space, çok çalışırsanız bir vector space'iniz olur ileride. If you have a vector space and take a vector from that vector space. Vector space var. Bir tane vektör aldınız. If you take any vector from this vector space, if you multiply this with scalars, you will get other elements of this vector space. Değil mi? If you have V, you will have C times V. Because your vector space is closed under scalar multiplication. And if you have V1 and V2, then V1 plus V2 also belongs to your vector space. Or if you have V1 and V2, C1 times V1 plus C2 times V2 is also an element of your vector space. What we are going to do next is we are going to start with a vector space as usual. Then we are going to consider a subset, just a set of vectors from the vector space. Tamam. And then we are going to consider all linear combinations, this type of expression C1 times V1 plus C2 times V2 is called a linear combination. Tamam. Linear means there is no degree 2 term. C1 times V1. Tamam. Okay. Let us start. So this is span. And linear independence let V be a vector space over a field F one if V1 Vm are elements of V are elements of V then every vector of the form then every vector of the form C1 V1 plus C2 V2 CM VM with C1, C2, C3, F is called a linear combination. Linear combination of V1 Bebe filmler dalıyor ya, göz göz ediyoruz, tamam. Birazdan gidip kantini soyacağız. Olsan ikili yeniden kuruyoruz. Okay. Now, next, we are going to define. So this is what we mean by a linear combination of a set of elements from a vector space V. Then we are going to define what we mean by span of these elements. So here, let us assume that we have a subset. This is not a subspace, but just a subset. You pick a set of vectors from your vector space, say, call this subset S for a subset S. Of V, the set of all linear combinations, linear combinations of elements. Çok yaşam. Kim yapıştırdın? Çok yaşa dedim. Ben mesela yabancı öğrencilere ilk öğrettiğim şey o. Hapşırıcı çok güzel. Evet. So S is called the linear span of the linear span of S and is denoted by so this is the notation that we are going to use, but sometimes you can see such notations or span. Now we are going to agree on one thing. We are going to assume that, of course, this set being a subset of a given vector space, this set can be en popüler subset hangisidir? Elif. Sen neydin? Pelin işte. Ha. Aslında Pelin. En favori subsetin hangisi? Ne demek istediğimi anlamadı tabii ki. Empty set. Self de olur. Sen mi söyledin arkadaşım? Ha? Evet. Adın ne senin?
Evet.
Tamam. Herkesin ismini öğreneceğim. Okay. We are going to agree on one thing. If this subset is the empty set, we are going to assume that the spinning set will consist of the zero vector. We are going to assume this because later I'm going to say that take any subset of a vector space, then the spinning set, this linear span, will form a subspace. Let me emphasize one more time. this is just an arbitrary subset of your vector space. And then you consider all possible linear combinations here in linear span. You consider all possible linear combinations of the elements from S. We are going to prove that the linear span is always a subspace. Tamam? Okay, so let us agree on this. When S is the empty set, we define span S as like this. Let me write last part of this definition. So again, you have a vector space, you take a subset of this vector space. It may happen that when you consider all possible linear combinations of the elements in S, you may get your vector space. Oh. That is, if every vector of V is a linear combination of elements of S, then we say that our vector space V is spanned by span or generated or generated by S. Okay. In this case, S is called a set of generators or a spanning set of V. Okay. So this third case will be important for us. We will look for, given a vector space, we will look for spanning sets for our vector spaces. Actually, we are going to look for the minimal such spanning sets. We want to generate our vector space using as small number of elements as possible. Tamam? Yes. Hayır. Şurada we will start with a set of vectors. Tamam. V1, V2, Vm. And then, so this is, let's say that this is our set S. When I say span S, then I mean all possible linear combinations of V1, V2, Vm. Tamam. That is called a linear span of your set. It will not always give you all the vectors in V. Tamam. Bir dahaki ders örnek yapacağız. Sen ne diyeceksin? Tamam. A'yı. Not da almıyorsun. Sen nereye alıyorsun? Sen bir tanesini bile yazmadın if'leri. İki tane varmış. Sen birini bile yazmadın. Şimdi çekme oley, yürü be falan diye şey yapıyorlar. Tamam, ara veriyoruz. We will meet in 50 minutes. Okay, we were discussing spanning, so spanning sets. We take a subset of a given vector space, just a set of vectors, and then we consider all of their linear combinations. If they happen to give you all the vectors in our vector space, then it is called a spanning set for our original vector space. Let me give you an example. First, like this. For example, let us take our favorite vector space, R2. Now, give me a spanning set for this vector space. So you are familiar with these vectors. If you just take these two vectors, and if you consider their linear combinations, you can get any vector from your vector space. So here, so then we say, when you look at the span of this subset, you just take two vectors from your vector space. This is your subset S. And then when you consider, so this is a real vector space for us. So here you have elements of this form. This is how a linear span, linear combination of these elements will look like. Okay, now if you see it the way that I wrote on the right hand side, you can easily see that these two vectors gives a spanning set for the vector space R2. Tamam? Now, for example, you can either take these vectors. So now this is a vector in our vector space, a polynomial of degree zero, x squared, x cubed. Of course, these will, if you just consider the span of these four vectors, it will give you your vector space, the vector space of polynomials whose degree are less than or equal to 3. Helen, tamam mı? Okay, so of course you may add more vectors here. For example, you may write x squared minus x. Because actually you can obtain any elements, the spanning set, if v is equal to, if v is equal to s, it doesn't, now for the time being, this set is not necessarily the minimal set, minimal number of elements. For example, we are going to see that you cannot obtain all the vectors in R3 just using a single vector. You need at least two. Huh? Two is the minimum possible number of elements. Using linear combinations, you can obtain all the vectors in R2. So they are going to have minimal spanning sets, will have a special name. Tamam mıyız burada? Good. Any questions? No. Good. Another example. Let us take this set of vectors from R3 to 1, negative 3, 1, negative 2, 4. We are going to see this as a subset of are three give me a vector which is in the spanning set of these two vectors. Give me, sen olsan bir tane vektör söyle, kafadan at. 4 is this vector in question?
Some kind of generate four, five, six, eight.
If the second component is negative, then the third component is positive, and if the third component is negative, the second component is positive.
Okay, now let me tell. So to check these results, so let me tell you this. In the spanning set, we have these elements. Again, this is important. You start with a vector space over a field F. If you don't specify anything, if you take Rn, we are going to see it as a real vector space. Scalars will come from R field R. So here you have C1 times 2, 1, negative 3, plus C2 times 1, negative 2, 4. And such that C1 and C2 is a real number. So this is your spanning set, the linear span of these two vectors. If you want to see 4, 5, 6, if you want to check whether 4, 5, 6 is such an element, you should be able to solve. So the elements here are 2C1 plus C2, C1 minus 2C2, and then minus 3C1 plus 4C2. We have such elements in this linear span of these two vectors. Okay. Now for this vector to lie in this set, we should have solution to these equations. For C1 minus 2C2 is equal to 5, negative 3C1 plus 4C2 is equal to 6. How many unknowns are there? 2. How many equations? 3. So let's use the first two equations and obtain C1 and C2, and then check the third equation whether that solution is an honest solution or not. Bunu çözüyoruz hep beraber. Çözdük. C1 ne çıktı? C2 ne çıktı? Şimdi böyle duruyorsunuz ya, hiç kimse çözmüyor. Kaç buldun sen? Sen? C1 mi? 13 over 5. C2. Minus 6 over 5. If you use the first two equations, then you will get C1 is 13 over 5. C2 is minus 6 over 5. Let's check the third equation. Minus 3 times 13 over 5. Plus bir minus 4 times 6 over 5. Now you can check that this is not equal to 6. Yani 30 etmiyor yukarısı. Tamam. So this element is not in this spherical center. Tamam. Any element of this form, any vector of this form will be in this linear span. Tamam mıyız? Peki. Tan of anar, tan over snow, 10.6. Tamam. C1, 3, 1, 5. Güzel. I was wrong. I agree anar. Okay. But that is the idea. Okay. Good. Now, sen ne dedin? Ha?
Kaya.
Tamam. Give me a vector in the linear span of these two vectors. Give me a vector in the linear span of these two vectors. Çok güzel. Aferin. Benim de aklımdan direkt o geçti. 3. So if you add these two vectors, so take C1 is as 1, C2 as 1. This vector is in the linear span. C1 is 1, C2 is 0. This vector is in the linear span. C1, 0, C2, 1. Or take C1 is equal to 1 and C2 is equal to 1. What will you get? 3 minus 1, 1. This is in the spanning set. In the linear span of these two vectors. Tamam. Anlaştık mı? Okay, now what is important about linear span of a subset of a vector space is you can start with an arbitrary subset of a vector space. When you consider the linear span, it will become a... Bu cümle nasıl bitebilir? Bu filmin mutlu sonu nedir? That linear span is a start with a vector space V. Take an arbitrary subset of V, let's call it S. Then linear span of S is a, bak beni ne durumlara düşürdün. Ayşe Nazlı Erona, şimdi evet diyeceğim, kızacağız, yine salona doğru koşacak. Is a vector space. Subspace. Good. Tamam. Tamam. Sen de kendimi görüyorum böyle. Öne oturup böyle dinleyip hoca ne diyor. Benim aklıma cevaplar geçerdi. Söylemeye cesaret edemezdim. %90'ı çok alakasız çıkardı. Teorem. Ayşe Nazlı Erona, seninki de doğru. Koş. Teorem. If S is any subset of a vector space of a vector space V, let's make this. Let's write this carefully over a field F. Then the linear span of the subset is a subspace. Okay, so there is this one half. So you need to make, if you want to write a complete proof, you should also include this case. S is an arbitrary subset of a vector space, so potentially it can be the empty set. So by our convention, the linear span of empty set is the unique element set. It will have zero vector only, and it is a subspace. So proof: if the subset is the empty set, then we have now let's assume that S is not the empty set. So if it is not the empty set, there must be a vector in the set. Say V is in S. Then, so we want to show that, this is a subspace. Ne oluyor? Bu surat ifadesi ne öyle? Evet, when I was in primary school. Sergiden ders alıyor musunuz? Sergiden. Evet, biz de alırdık böyle 3. 4. sınıfta. Bir şey bilemiyor. Aa, bunu nasıl bilmezsiniz? Biz bunları high school'da yapıyorduk falan böyle iyice ve eziklerdi bizi. Evet. So remember long long time ago, that is in the last class, we agree on one thing. Because S is an arbitrary subset of a vector space. What is a vector space? It is after all a set of vectors. So if you consider, if you say I have, let S be an arbitrary subset of a set, potentially it can be the empty set, because empty set is the subset of every set, değil mi? So for us to be able to write such a statement, we agree on last lecture that the linear span of the empty set is a one element set, the zero vector. Tamam. So that this theorem will make sense. İki tane if var. Then if then evet. Tamam. Now what should I need to show?
It is closed algebraic.
How many steps? Two. How many steps? Two.
Three.
Tamam. One non-empty. Why? Because if V is in S, then V is in spanning set. Remember this example. This element is also in the spanning set. Tamam. Okay. You can say the zero vector is in the spanning linear span. You can argue that I will multiply this with the scalar zero, but you already have this element. So this set is non-empty. Nazlı'nın arkadaşı senin adın ne? Çağan. Erkek ismi mi var? Ha? Ha, tamam. Çinler sen kendi adına bakıyorsun değil mi? Benim adım Kıbrıs'tan geliyor. Mehmetçik köyü var orada. Biliyormuş ki ama anlaşmamız gereği. Tamam. So this set is non-empty since V is in. Tamam. Anlaştık. Sen eksik kaldın burada.
Ne diyecek? Yani f boş bir oluyorsa ben f spanet'in zero vektör içermesi çok saçma. O zaman baştan şey diye biterim ben. Any non-empty subset.
Tamam öyle de dese de olur. Tamam. Ama öyle dememek için genelde böyle bir anlaşma yaptım. Şimdi aslında şöyle bir şey var. Geçen ders dedim, sesini çıkartmadı. O zaman diyeydin. Ha, dinlemiyorsun o zaman. Aferin. Seneye dinlersin. Any questions? Tamam neyse oraları çok şey yapmayın. Yani, tamam. Oraya takılmayın. Öyle de desen olur. Ama şunu unutma yani. Şöyle bir konuşmamız var. Evet. So this is so first of all, for the time being, this is a subset. This is a non-empty subset. What should I show next? As Yıldız mentioned, we need to show that this is closed under addition. So I need to take two elements from this linear span. Let let u1 comma u2 şöyle diyeyim. Let u comma omega is in this spanning set. Tamam. So to make our work easier, let us assume that this here let us assume that S is V1 M. So if U is in the linear span, it means U is equal to C1 V1 plus Cm Vm. Omega is D1 V1 Dn Bm Ci Di is an element of the field for I 1 through M. Tamam. Söyle. Okay, even if S is an infinite set, even if it's an infinite set, when you take a linear combination, we will always take, when I say a linear span, you will only take finitely many non-zero scalars. If there are infinitely many elements in your set, when you take a linear combination, you will not consider a series type of summations. In this course, when I say linear span, I will always mean finitely many linear combination like this. Tamam. So this also makes sense in infinite case, but for the time being, let's stay away from such cases. Tamam. Because there is this problem. If you take an infinite sum, you should tell a way to make sense of that infinite sum. So we will stay away from those problems. Okay, now if you consider u plus omega, now you can easily see that this is c1 plus d1 times v1 plus cn plus dm times vm. Now both c and d, c1 and d1, it is from a field. There are two operations on a field, two binary operations. Field is closed under addition, scalar. So this is also an element of your field, and this is also an element of your field. So this sum can be expressed as a linear combination of the elements of S. So what does this tell you? This is in S. Okay. And subspace. Tamam mı?
3. So it is, if U is in the spinning set and with the similar assumption, let's work with finite spinning sets, finite sets. Then Q is of this form. For any d, any scalar from your field, d times vector u. So let me put an arrow here. D is a scalar, u is a vector. Then you know that the scalar multiplication can distribute over addition.
Benim surat ifadesine bakınca ben burada Japonca konuşuyorum. Tamam mı? Any questions? Ayrıca tamamen böyle sessiz sinema. Nedir bu? Hocayla dalga geçilmez. Tam gözüm şaşı da sana arada şuna bak. O grup olduğu gibi sen bir tek arkadaki arkadaş dedirgin değil. Sen. Tamam. D times U is, so this is D times C1 times V1. So this is a scalar, this is a vector. D times Cm times Vm. As you see, this is, because we are working over a field, if you multiply two numbers, it will again be an element of your field. And similarly, this is in F. So this element also belongs to S. So closed under scalar multiplication. Closed under addition, closed under scalar multiplication, a non-empty set. So you can start an arbitrary subset. You can start with an arbitrary subset of your vector space. If you consider the linear span of your vector space, it is a subspace. Always keep this in mind. R2. How can you span R2? 1, 0, 0, 1. 1, 0, and 0, 1. If you consider the linear span of these two vectors, it gives you the whole vector space. Tamam. In R2, if I do not play with your cell phone. Bana yalancı mı demek istiyorsun?
Ama oynamayacaktım. Boş
kümenin kendine bakacak. Boş kümenin? Hayır yani şimdi yalancı demedim ama inanmıyorum. Yanlış söyledin. Kontrol edeceğim. Yani internete güveniyorsun.
Hayır, o benim sadece...
İşte bak mesela senin gibiler var böyle. Mesela benim liseden arkadaşlarım var. Bana derslerde gıcıklık yaptı. Hala burada işte.
Hayır.
Kantinde gösteririm. Gelirler akşama doğru. Akar burası böyle. Akar. Kemikler çıkıyor.
Evet. Okay. Let me ask you a question. So again in R2. Take a non-zero vector. Yaman bir tane non-zero vector söyle R2'da. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2. Hadi başlayalım. Hep beraber. What is the linear span of the vector 1, 2 in R2? 1, 2, you take a non-zero vector. 1, 2. What is the linear span of 1, 2? Söyle. What is an equation?
Y equals 2x.
Kim söyledi?
Yeah. Tamam. Evet. If you consider in R2, okay, e.g. V is equal to R2. Now, if you consider this vector 1, 2, suppose this is your subspace. You have a subspace you have a subspace consisting of just a single element, non-zero vector. Now, if you consider the linear span of this vector, what do you have here? Multiples of this vector. In R2, if you multiply this vector, you will obtain a line passing through the origin whose direction vector is this one. And this line is also known as y is equal to 2x line. Tamam. Anlaştık. Evet, Yaman'dayız. Aldım hafızanı sizlere. Tamam mıyız? In R3. Sen. Senin adın ne? Yok, senin önündeki ne? Ne kadar kötü bir şey. Ben sizin fiziksel özelliklerinizle dalga geçiyorum değil mi? Sen kırmızı kazaklar. Çok ayıp yani. Sen Allah bilir içinden dört göz falan da diyorsundur bana. Oha! Hala kırmızı değil o. Tamam. Ne o? Ne ne? Vişne çürüğü. Kiremit. Tamam. Hayır. Kiremit. Ben de kırmızı diyeceksin sanırsın. Evet. Kiremit kazaklı arkadaşım. Senin adın ne? Abdurrahman. Bak Abdurrahman iyi bir şey olabilir. Böyle bir tane öğrenci vardı bizde. Sarı kazağı vardı. Ben de böyle dalga geçmişti. Sarı diye adı kaldı. Nerede çalıştığını şu an size ilerleyen aşamalarda söyleyeyim. Mezun oldu. Evet Kiremit. Neydi adın? Ya Kiremit. Tamam. Kiremit. Say. In R3. Give me two vectors. One, two, three. Okay. In R2. In R3. These are your vectors. One, two, three. One, two, three. Two, four, six. 1, 2, 3, 2, 4, 6. What is the linear span of these two vectors? Şurada şey yapayım sizin için. Ne? Okay, in R3, another example. V is equal to R3. Your set is 1, 2, 3. 2, 4, 6. Now, what is so special about these two vectors? One of them is a multiple of the other. So actually, when you consider a linear span, you don't need to consider this one. Because this is already twice of this vector. So you can consider just, so the linear span of these two vectors is multiples of this vector. So in R3 you will get a line whose direction vector is 1, 2, 3. Tamam. Anlaştık mı? What is the linear span of these two vectors? Two vectors. If they are, so if one of them is not a multiple of the other, so they are diğer vektörsler. Play. Ayşe Nazlı Aronat. Şey. Yeniden Zafer Turun'a çıkıyor. Play. Very nice. It will be a play. If, because if you have two vectors in R3, which is if they are not parallel, because parallel vector means one of them is a multiple of the other. If they are not parallel, they will give you a play. Tamam. Of course, when I say a plane in this course, I better mean plane passing through the origin. Tamam? Anlaştık. Good. Very good. Okay, so let me write what you said here. Remark, as a remark. So in this remark, what I want to tell you is, even if the set, the subset S contains infinitely many elements, when I say a linear combination, I will always consider the combination of finitely many of them. Tamam. the set S can have infinitely many elements, but a linear combination has only finite many elements. Okay. Tamam. Tamam. Now if you take an arbitrary set of vectors from your vector space, then it is linear span is a subspace. Cepte. This linear span has one additional property. It is the smallest subspace containing all the vectors in that set. Tamam, let me write this also. Moreover, this linear span of the set S is the smallest subspace containing the set S. So let's give an explanation for this one. So suppose şuradaki nokta var. Aklı üstü. Suppose this is your set and suppose this is a this is contained in V0, which is also a subspace of V. Now, so what does this mean? A subspace of V. So V0 contains all the elements in S. So again, let's think this S as V1, V2, Vn. They are all contained in V0. V0 is a subspace, or you can think it as a vector space. If V1 and V2 are in V0, for example, then all their linear combination must also be in V0. Because if V1 is in V0, then all multiples of V1 should be in V0. Resmen sana özel anlatıyorum işte. If V1 is here, V2 is in V0, then their sum, their multiples, they all belong to V0. So what I want to say is, if all the elements of V, if all the elements of this set is contained in V0, and since V0 is a vector space by itself, then all the linear combinations of the elements of this set must belong to V0. So V0 must contain all linear combinations of this set. So in particle, it must contain the linear span. Since V sub zero contains all linear combinations, of elements of S,
Tamam. Now, before I finish, I will give you some exercises. Can. Değil mi? Any questions? Ayşe Nazlı hala Zafer turunda herhalde. Ses çıkmıyor. Evet, Ayşe Nazlı Eronat. Kim acaba ya? Efendim. Tamam. Burada mısın diye bir merak ettim. Okay. Now here are as I told you. Study from your notes. Find any book, any suggested book will work. Try to solve exercises. I will also write exercises in the class. Exercises. One. S is a subspace of V if and only if linear span of S is equal to S. Tamam. Two, let V be a vector space and AB are subsets of V. Prove or disprove the following. Prove or disprove means give a counter example. Prove or disprove the following. A, if A is a subset of B, then linear span of A is also contained in linear span of B. Part two, consider A union B, then is this equal to linear span of A plus linear span of B. Part C, A intersection B and linear span of A intersection linear span of B. Part D, and a question. Tamam, neyse. Sınavda soruyorum. Yok yok, alakasız. Yanlış yazmışım. Tamam. Okay, do you have any questions? In next week we are going to give a special name to spanning sets for a given vector space. Namely, we are going to call them as bases, and the number of elements in any basis will be the same. It will be called the dimension. Tamam, done.